Shalom Talmidim and Bruchim Abayim to Regah Bivrit. We are almost finished with the book of Genesis, Bereshit, and this week we are Parashat Vayigash, the climatic meeting between Yosef and his brothers and this reconciliation that is occurring between them. Now, there are two climatic meetings. One climatic meeting is between Yosef and his brothers, but the other climatic meetings is between Yosef and his father. I want you to pay attention in Genesis 45 to the preparation of the meeting between Yosef and Yaakov. We can learn something very important from the Hebrew language here. We're going to pick up today in Genesis chapter 45, verse 25, and it says, Vaya'alu mimitzrayim, vayavou eretz Kanaan el Yaakov aviem. And they left Egypt, and they're coming to eretz Kanaan, to Yaakov aviem. We need to pay attention to the words here. When we see this language, it's already telling us that something is happening in the text. It doesn't say they left Egypt. It actually says Vaya'alu from the word Aliyah. And they went Aliyah, they meant Aliyah from Egypt up to the land. Remember earlier, it says Vayerdu, Yerida. And here the text says Vaya'alu from the word, from the Lashon of the word Aliyah. They are going up. Something spiritually has changed in the heart of the brothers. And I want everybody to understand it. When we see this term, Ya'alu Aliyah, it's talking about something spiritual that is happening here. And then they say Vayagidu, Vayagidulo, and they speak to Yaakov. Lemo, and pay attention that his name is Yaakov here. This is very quite important. And they say to him, here's the message they're giving him, Od Yosef Chai. Yosef is alive. Veki hu Moshel. He is a ruler. Not only that he is alive, he is a ruler. Bechol Eretz Mitzrayim Vayafag Libo. This is a very interesting, strange language that the Torah uses here. It says that Yaakov did not believe them, and it says that something is happening in his heart. It's used the word vayafag. The word vayafag is a very strange Hebrew word. It's come from the word hafuga. Hafuga means to have a break, stop. Literally, the text is translated the word yafag. It's literally mean his heart stop beating. That's literally what the text says. Yaakov's heart stopped beating, okay? Kilo emilim, because he didn't believe to them. And look at us, this is amazing. Vaydaber elav, et kol divrei Yosef asher diber elehem, so they tell him, vayireh et ha'agalot, and he saw the wagons, okay? Asher shalach Yosef, they see the wagons full with the food, okay? Laset oto. Remember the rule that says that ma'asei avot, what the fathers went through, siman labanim, it's a sign for the children. Okay, this is a prophecy now, okay? Asher, listen, look to the language here in verse 27. Asher shalach Yosef laset oto, that Joseph sent this wagon not for the food. It's amazing. He didn't send the wagons full of food for the food. He sent it to carry Yaakov. Interesting. Laset oto, and look what happened. This is amazing. Vatechi ruach Yaakov aviem. And Yaakov, it says, received the techi. The word techi, it's come from the Hebrew word techiya. Techiya mean resurrection. What is happening to Yaakov when he's reconciling with Yosef? A resurrection is okay. The word techi is from the word chia. He is becoming resurrection. Vatechi ruach Yaakov aviyam. Okay? Vayomer, and look what is happening. His name then changes. Vayomer Israel, Rav od Yosef, Bni Chai Elcha, Vere'enu Beterem Amut. Okay? It's interesting because now he's not called Yaakov, he's called Israel. And he said, let's go see my son before I die. You see, there is interesting thing here to care. It says that his spirit went through something called Tehi. Tehiya is rooted in the Hebrew word Chai. We always say it, Od Avinu Chai, Am Israel Chai. But what really is the word Chai mean? The word chai does not mean to live, but the word chai means to be resurrected. In essence, the clue here in the text telling us that the spirit of Yaakov was dead, and when he received the message of his son, his spirit was resurrected. Just as the Jewish people, when they meet Yosef, who is the ruler of the Egyptian, who is the, really the king, just like David, will be resurrected when they will meet the Mashiach again. So he went from his heart stopped beating to a complete and utter resurrection. Isn't it interesting that Yeshua identified himself as the Lord of the resurrection, the one who gave Chaim? That's an amazing, absolutely fascinating message by Mashiach. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this pearl, this Regah Bivrit, that is give you some more insight to the Hebrew language. Pay attention to the Hebrew, and let's continue to study Hebrew together. God bless you. Litraot Talmidim.